things fall apart, they fall apart fast. If you look at the ISM report, manufacturing's in recession. The service sector is barely treading water.
The Fed is fighting a pretty entrenched inflation right now. And so the possibility of recession, I think, is still there. And early 2024 seems like it's a reasonable possibility.
Everyone wants you to believe that all is well and the economy has made it to a soft landing. But here is the truth no one is talking about. A recession is coming. Economist David Rosenberg asserts an 85% likelihood that the U.S. economy will experience a recession in 2024. He underscores the effectiveness of a relatively new economic model, which has shown superior timeliness compared to traditional indicators like the yield curve. Our conviction that the recession has been delayed but not derailed is still running at a high level, he explains. This economic indicator, dubbed the full model by Rosenberg, suggests an 85% probability of a recession within the next 12 months, marking its highest prediction since the 2008 Great Financial Crisis. The model is based on a National Bureau of Economic Research paper and incorporates financial conditions indexes, the debt service ratio, foreign term spreads, and the level of the yield curve. Rosenberg asserts the model's superiority, citing its track record of accurately signaling recessions without issuing false alarms since 1999. He contrasts its prediction with that of the yield curve indicator, which in early 2023 suggested a 50% chance of recession, while the full model indicated only a 12% probability. The full model predicted the soft landing we saw in 2023, but now is saying that for 2024, recession probabilities are highly elevated, Rosenberg says. The model challenges the prevailing narrative, suggesting the economy is poised for a soft landing, or even avoiding a landing scenario this year. He warned that if a recession were to materialize, it could spell disaster for the stock market. Few asset classes are prepared for such an outcome, despite recessions being an inherent part of the business cycle and typically following a prolonged period of Fed rate hikes continuing beyond yield curve inversion, Rosenberg cautioned. Rosenberg's model also sheds light on why the widely monitored yield curve indicator has failed to accurately predict a recession thus far. It elucidates why the yield curve failed to signal a recession in 2017 to 19. Accommodative financial conditions, remarkably low debt obligations, and favorable foreign term spreads offset the signal from the inverted U.S. yield curve, Rosenberg explained. However, he suggests that this scenario is on the brink of change, with the long-anticipated recession looming. Strategists further elaborate that in 2023, the Federal Reserve's rate hikes and the uptick in U.S. Treasury debt issuance effectively injected economic stimulus through higher interest payments. The surprise factor for 2024 lies in how the convergence of heightened policy restraint globally, the reduction in fiscal support from the U.S. federal government, and the increased uncertainty surrounding the U.S. general election propel the economy into a hard landing, they highlighted. In late January, Mizuho strategist Dominic Konstam stressed during an interview with Bloomberg TV, the impending economic downturn will materialize as a significant rise in unemployment, forecasting unemployment rates to potentially reach 6% or 7% by year-end. Konstam asserts that the declining inflation rate will be the catalyst for a deterioration in the labor market. As prices stabilize or decrease, company earnings and profits will be impacted, leading to a cessation of labor hoarding practices and subsequent workforce reductions. He emphasized, "The decrease in inflation is not merely a benign signal indicating a smooth transition such as, oh, we've achieved it, we've secured a soft landing. On the contrary, the decline in inflation serves as a warning sign, suggesting, oh my goodness, exercise caution now. What will happen to the labor market 6 months from now?" These cautionary notes have been backed up by other economists and investors, prompting us to be wary of what lies ahead for the U.S. economy. Jason Cummins, a prominent economist at the hedge fund Brevan Howard, also cautions that although the U.S. may have narrowly avoided a recession last year, the prospects for 2024 are not as favorable. In Bloomberg's Odd Lots podcast, Cummins highlighted that monetary policy remains excessively tight to achieve a smooth economic landing akin to the Sully Sullenberger soft landing of all soft landings. Currently, monetary policy is at its tightest, on the verge of a recession, Cummins stated, with the only exception being in 1984. The Federal Reserve has aggressively raised interest rates, marking the swiftest pace in four decades. Rates climbed from nearly zero levels in March 2022 to 5.25%, 5.5% by July 2023. Cummins cautioned that this tightening monetary stance is burdening the economy. He pointed out that household survey data indicates a significant decline in the number of individuals transitioning from unemployment to employment. A thorough examination of the labor market suggests that hiring has come to a standstill, he remarked. If not for a substantial drop in labor force participation, as evidenced by a 3/10 decline in the latest report, the unemployment rate would have risen by the same magnitude to 4%. The issue arises from the Federal Reserve's significant miscalculation regarding the duration of persistently high inflation, leading to an overly aggressive rate hike response. As of June 2023, the Fed held a median forecast of 3.9% for core PCE inflation. However, projections indicate that this estimate is expected to be off by 100 basis points, with core PCE inflation anticipated to reach 2.9% by the end of January, as cited by Cummins. In December, core inflation registered an annual increase of 3.2%. Cummins remarked, "They've never missed in that direction by that magnitude," highlighting that even a slight deviation in 2019 resulted in a 75 basis point mid-cycle adjustment. Mark B. Spiegel of Stanfield Capital also released his latest investor letter on January 31, 2024, presenting his updated perspective on the market's valuation. Meanwhile, the recession that I and many leading indicators predicted hasn't yet arrived, and thus our large SPY short position continues to hurt us, despite today's post-Fed meeting slide. However, not yet arriving isn't the same as not arriving, and I strongly believe that a recession will appear in the first half of this year, and the expensive stock market will suffer severely from it. The consensus is now for either no landing or a soft landing. Yet before even the worst recessions, the consensus is nearly always for a soft landing. In fact, for reasons I clearly lay out below, I still strongly believe that the US economy is headed for a hard landing. Meanwhile, the stock market has been rallying fiercely in response to the lessening inflation, which is a natural precursor to the hard landing, I expect. So now, despite myriad lurking dangers, both economic and geopolitical, the market is now extremely overbought, and investor sentiment is quite bullish. An earlier note had emphasized the same things. There's no way an everything bubble built on over a decade of 0% interest rates and trillions of dollars of worldwide quantitative easing cannot implode when confronted with 5% plus rates and $95 billion per month in US quantitative tightening, plus tighter money from the ECB, BOJ, and other central banks. Contrary to the belief of equity bulls, bubbles don't unwind gently, and once they burst and the economy takes a dive, it takes a long time before lower inflation and lower rates help stock prices. When the 2000 bubble burst, the NASDAQ was down 83% through its 2002 low, and the S&P 500 was down 50%. The rates of CPI inflation were just 3.4% in 2000, 2.8% in 2001, and 1.6% in 2002. And the Fed was cutting rates almost the entire time. Yes, a nasty recession has been delayed due to a combination of interest rate lag effects, leftover COVID cash, and labor hoarding. But it will soon arrive for the following reasons. Although the excess savings built up during the COVID pandemic kept a floor under consumer spending, those funds are now fully depleted for most Americans, and consumer credit card delinquencies are now rapidly increasing while personal savings have collapsed. Business lending data, shipping container data, an inverted 2-10 yield curve, bankruptcy filings, declining job openings, and other leading indicators say that a nasty recession is imminent. The cost of servicing the federal debt is soaring, as is the liquidity draining rate of its issuance, thereby making extra fiscal stimulus unaffordable. On October 1st, student loan repayments will finally resume, although admittedly, many debtors will undoubtedly utilize the Biden administration's one-year grace period. In December 2023, J.P. Morgan Stanley echoed concerns that the U.S. economy might unexpectedly slide into a recession in 2024. Similarly, Evercore Chairman Ed Hyman delivered a somber forecast in 2023, warning of an impending recession anticipated to endure until mid-2024. He attributed this forthcoming downturn to the Federal Reserve's steadfast commitment to monetary tightening, particularly notable as other major central banks, such as the European Central Bank, concurrently pursued similar policies. Hyman emphasized the compounding effect on the economy when multiple central banks implement tightening measures simultaneously, amplifying the severity of the repercussions. Delving into the intricacies of monetary policy, Hyman referenced economist John Keynes's research, suggesting that the full impact of the Fed's tighter policy typically takes approximately 16 months to materialize. This temporal lag implies that although early warning signs of economic distress are already evident, it may take another year before the complete consequences of the Fed's actions emerge. Hyman highlighted several indicators signaling economic turbulence, including the contraction in the money supply due to recent banking failures and the troubling inversion of the 2-10 Treasury yield curve, a widely recognized precursor of recession. Expressing astonishment at the notion of forecasting a recession so far ahead, Hyman proposed that the Fed could make adjustments to interest rates, which presently stand at 5.25%, the highest level since 2007. In line with Hyman's evaluation, numerous experts and commentators over the past year have raised concerns about the increasing risk of recession. This apprehension has been intensified by the collective actions of central banks worldwide to raise interest rates and shrink the Fed's balance sheet in an effort to alleviate inflationary pressures. This coordinated tightening of monetary policy, characterized by higher interest rates and rapid withdrawal of liquidity, significantly amplifies the economy's susceptibility to entering a downturn. Notably, in May 2023, reports surfaced indicating a 68% likelihood of the U.S. slipping into a recession within the subsequent 12 months, as indicated by the New York Fed's Recession Probability Index in April. The long-prophesied recession is closer now than ever before. It's no longer a matter of if, but when. With warnings increasing and economic uncertainty rising, it's crucial to pay attention and prepare. Tightening monetary policies, reduced fiscal support, and geopolitical tensions are set to unsettle the economy. Though we can't predict the exact intensity of this recession, its effects will likely ripple through various sectors, reshaping markets and impacting livelihoods.